What's up, guys? We're back. So now we're going to talk about elements versus attributes and what an attribute is. Now, elements are made up of two tags, an opening tag and a closing tag. So for example, this heading here, we have the opening tag, H1, and then closing tag. What do? They tell the browser information that is between the two tags. So for a paragraph tag, it's telling them that there's text here. For an H1 or a heading tag, it's telling the browser there's a heading here. And then for the body tags, it's telling it that everything between these tags makes up the web content that's visible. That's the basic level of what elements do. Now, what's the difference between a tag and an element? Not a whole lot. They're almost one and the same. But if we're getting technical, the angle brackets, so the brackets on either side here, are the element, and the P in the middle tags that element as a P element. So you'll hear a lot of, if you're out there and you're coding, you'll hear people refer to them as tags. Very, very acceptable, common practice. Are they elements? Yes. Are they tags? Yes. If you get a question on a quiz, it's an element. So now let's talk about attributes. Attributes give a little bit more information about a particular element. More functionality. Many, but not all, HTML elements allow you to set attributes. An attribute is an additional code within an opening element tag. And that's the keyword here, opening. So I added an attribute here in the paragraph. So it says class equals test. It's in the opening paragraph tag. We would never see an attribute in a closing tag. When we use an attribute, we are providing two pieces of information, an attribute name and the value that we are assigning to that attribute. Now, although it's made up of two parts, you're always going to have three characters, the attribute name of class, the equal sign, and then the value. So again, two parts, but three pieces when we throw in that equal sign there. Now, attributes are important. They help us down the road when we start to apply CSS in the next few weeks, because when we write our CSS, which is how we style this so that all websites out there don't just have your basic core, your new font text with white backgrounds, the way that we get the styles that we desire is by using CSS. And CSS looks at our attributes in order to determine where to apply the styles that we want. So, for example, the class attribute, later on when we do CSS, we'll say, when we see the test class, make the font, for example, blue. So, attributes may not seem like they're doing a whole lot for you now, but just know they definitely come in handy when we start to apply some style. Now, attributes are specific to the element that they're assigned. So, this class attribute is specific to this paragraph element. And some attributes only go with specific elements. But for example, I'm just going to type down here, which is of course outside of my HTML, so I'm just showing you an example. It could be the label element has an attribute that can be used of the word for, F-O-R, and then we would type in example name and then close that tag. So the for attribute can only be used with the label element. So we'll see more about that later when we start building some forms. So again, attributes are most important when we dive into CSS, but they are also important to HTML. So here, the red, I'm using Aptana Studio 3 in this example, it automatically made my attributes red, so they stand out. And we have the language attribute here, which tells the browser that this website is in English, that's what the EN stands for. And then in my head, I have meta char set UTF-8, so it's telling them what type of character encoding I am using. And then down here, again, we talked about the class attribute, which later on, if we were doing CSS, we can tell it that when it sees the test class, to apply the following styles to whatever paragraphs that have that attribute assigned. Now, you're thinking, okay, well, so attributes. What kind of attributes are there? Is this it? Oh, heck no. There's a lot of attributes out there. And once again, our friends over in W3C is always the best place to go. So I have this website pulled up for you here, w3schools.com. You could even just do a Yahoo search of HTML attributes. The very top one, not the ad, always stay away from the ads. The very top one takes you to the HTML attributes page, and it gives us the list of most commonly used attributes. The alt for alternative text, very important for accessibility. Disabled, which specifies that an input element should be disabled. href, which we'll start using when we play with links later on. The ID, very important for CSS. Source, you'll start to see this as we add links and or images to our pages. Style, which we will talk about with CSS. And then title, giving an element a title, which is displayed as a tooltip. So if you hover over something, then you'll get that tooltip if it has that attribute. But is this it? No, again, of course not. There are more attributes than you can memorize, but this is why it's important to understand there are resources out there that you can look up anytime you want to see what options you have available to you. So here's the link to the HTML attribute references, and then it gives us a full list. And as you can see, the list is very long. We will use a number of these in these video tutorials over the next few weeks, but not all of them. So I encourage you to go and take a look at the attributes and, when possible, give one a try. Play around with them, understand what they do. This reference sheet is helpful because not only does it give you the possible attributes, it tells you which element they belong to in the event they only work with specific elements. And it tells you what it does in the description. So a great reference to have. And that's it. I hope you have a better understanding on what attributes are. The only way you're really going to understand it is you get in and play with the code yourself. Be sure to subscribe to watch more videos, and I will see you next time.